I'm Dave from Thomas Jacks, and today we're going to be testing the brand new Pulsar Telos LRF XP50. This is the LRF model. You can get it with or without the LRF. And we brought it out today because we've had lots of rain already today, so the humidity is very high. Hopefully we'll get a little bit of rain, possibly some thunder, lightning, and some hail later. So we're going to be testing one of the best features on this, which is the sub 18 milli-Kelvin NETD value. By comparison, I've also brought with me its predecessor, the Pulsar Helion XP50 Pro. That's got a sub 25 milli-Kelvin sensor on it. So sub 25 milli-Kelvin versus brand new sub 18 milli-Kelvin.
On a tripod, I have a Telos XP50 and an LRF XP50, alongside a Helion XP50 Pro. Here's our first test, a farm and cows at 480 metres, sheep at 780 metres, and 2 kilometres away, the M40 motorway. That haze on the horizon is 93% humidity, which will affect any thermal. But our Helion on the left and our Telos on the right have a 640 by 480 17 micron sensor. Max digital zoom on the Telos is ×10. With the Helion set to the same, I'll freeze the action to help you spot the differences. Starting with the cows, the sub 18 milli-Kelvin Telos cuts through the high humidity better compared to the sub 25 milli-Kelvin Helion, so there's more defined edge detail and easier identification at 480 metres, even at high humidity. The trees in the Telos have more definition too, but both give us lots of detail on the farmhouse, right down to the chimney. And while the Helion can zoom to 20 times mag, the camera style zoom on the Telos is just brilliant. Now, a bit of close-up detail, and I'll hold the action there. It's difficult to match the contrast and brightness precisely, but at short range, there's hardly any water vapour to penetrate, so it's not surprising that both look really good. On to something more challenging. Sheep at 780 metres and the motorway at 2 kilometres. Freezing the action, starting with the motorway, I can count the lorry's wheels for both the Helion and the Telos. But even in the humidity, there's no fuzzy edge for the sub 18 milli-Kelvin Telos. The sheep look okay on both, with enough definition to count them, but the Telos shows us more of the farmhouse, which is much crisper and richer in tonal detail. I filmed one final scene with the Telos and Helion, this dog walker. A quick freeze frame here at 270 meters. Really nice image detail for both, but are you starting to think like me? Pulsar have just raised the bar again with a new Telos. And here's our dog walker at 60 metres. And now at 100 metres, with rabbits on the tree line at 230 metres. We didn't get the rain, lightning or hail promised by the weather forecasters, but the high humidity put the Telos to the test. So there you have it. If you want the best thermal for tricky weather conditions like high humidity, this is the one for the job. The Telos LRF XP50. If you'd like to see more videos like this, subscribe. Or for details of the Pulsar Telos, visit thomasjacks.co.uk. I'm Dave at Thomas Jacks. Thanks for watching.